Hi everybody, welcome to our cooking show, Cooking in the House. Today, we're going to be having our 12th episode. This is our 12th episode, but it's actually going to be our first time making a dessert. Today, we're going to be making chocolate pudding. This dessert may seem rather simple, but there are some things to pay attention to. We're going to talk about that later. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do to make chocolate pudding is we're going to combine sugar and cocoa powder together. This has 1 tablespoon of sugar, and we're going to add 2 tablespoons of this natural cocoa powder. You can use Dutch cocoa powder, but I don't recommend it. That would make it taste rather bitter. Next, in a pan, we're going to add 2 cups of flour into the pan. This is a cast iron pan, by the way. And then to this, we're going to add six tablespoons of cocoa. And this might seem like a lot, but this is a very chocolatey dessert. Six. One half stick of butter. This is only 4 ounces. Now I'm going to turn this on to medium heat. Alright, next what we're going to add is actually some sugar. This is part of sugar too. This is 1/2 cup. You can make it sweeter, but I usually don't. Then we're going to need some milk. This is also 1/2 cup. And then we're going to need about 1 teaspoon of vanilla. You might think that you don't need vanilla for a chocolate dessert, but you do. And we're just going to mix this together, and it's all going to come together quite nicely. After a period of time, this is going to start to look more like chocolate cake batter. Actually, this is a little bit dry. I'm going to get a little more milk. So next, we're going to need to get eggs to add to this. I always wash my eggs in water, but apparently people in the States don't have to. Alright, so moving on, we're going to drain these eggs to make sure they're all clean. Just be careful. And now we can use these. Alright, next we're going to be making some whipped cream as a topping for the pudding. Something about whipped cream, though, is that you want everything to be as cold as possible when you're whipping it. So then I put the bowl in our freezer ahead of time. I'm just going to get it out. I got the bowl. So yeah, this is about done whipping now. It's important not to over-whip whipped cream because then it'll seize up and there's no way to fix that without starting over. But anyway, we're going to actually switch to a sponsorship segment now. This video is sponsored in part by the Twelvella Company. Twelvella, digging deeper towards a better future. I'm actually gonna go figure out what that is. Just a minute. All right.
I want the door open. Let's try the back door.
Oh, that's what it is. I see now. The telly was too loud. Let's turn it down. And then that's all taken care of. Alright, now to finish off the pudding, what we're going to do is we're going to mix the sugar and cocoa from earlier together. And then we're just going to sprinkle this onto the pudding with a spoon.
and it's all dusted. We're going to finish it in the oven. I have it set to 350 Fahrenheit, and it's going to take about 15 minutes. So we'll be back when that's done. Hi. While our pudding is in the oven, now is like the perfect time to read some of the fan mail I get. This first one comes from Normal Fish. Normal Fish wants to ask, do I prefer gas or electric stoves? Which I just gotta say, Normal Fish, I condone the use of gas stoves like so much. I prefer them so much better than the electric. Next we have a letter from SansIsBoss21. He wants to ask, why do I always wash my eggs? In America, they don't have to wash their eggs. The reason, SansIsBoss, is because in America, your eggs already get washed by the grocery store. But in the UK, they don't wash their eggs. So something different about eggs in the UK and America is that in the UK, it's more safe to eat raw eggs than it is in America. But in America, you don't have to wash your eggs. There is a trade-off there. For our last letter, this one comes from Austrian Asterisk. He wants to ask, why do you always film in a different kitchen every episode? Do you travel to cook? The reason is because...
what are you doing in my house?
We're doing a cooking show.
A cooking show? In my house?
Yeah.
Okay, I guess.
Want to join? Get over here.
Guys. So I just called my parents, and I let them know that there's someone in our house. They said they didn't invite them. He claims to be filming a cooking show, but I had no prior knowledge of this, and I've never seen him in my life. So I'm going to go look up if Reddit knows anything about this, or maybe they can show me how to get him out of my house, because he's not supposed to be here. Wait, so according to Reddit, multiple other people have had the same occurrence happen, and it's been happening for the last 11 years? Supposedly it's a ghost? What? How do I get rid of a ghost? Aha! I found a Wikipedia article about how to kill a ghost. Oh look, and there's a video about how to kill a ghost.
So let's say your house is haunted by a ghost that won't leave, although they've clearly overstayed their welcome. What? Now what are we gonna do about that, even after we've politely asked them to leave?
Well, I've got the solution for you today.
You do? Holy water! It is able to banish ghosts back to the underworld. Now I'm gonna demonstrate how you can get rid of your ghost at home. First, take some holy water and splash.
And that's how you get rid of a ghost. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm gonna have to clean up this dead body now.
I know now what I must do. Call the police.
Hello? 911. What's your emergency?
Yes, I have a ghost in my house and it won't leave.
Have you tried using water?
Yeah, I splashed it with water, but it still won't go away.
Okay, stay calm and tie it up, then leave it in the living room if you want. You're going to send a precision airstrike right down your location. You're 5 minutes until it arrives.
Okay, I got it. Thank you.
Water isn't strong enough. You need to use holy water.
Where did you get that from? I got the holy water.
Chef.
What is it?
Take this.
Yeah.
That was very rude. Please refrain from doing that. Alright, so now our pudding is nearly done. We just have to get it out of the oven.
All right, I can't wait.
I can't wait to see how it looks.
Oh, wow.
And here it is. Now we're gonna top it with some whipped cream.
Oh, whipped cream? You know what would go good with that? We actually have a berry bush in the front yard that we can use to garnish it with.
You do?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a great idea. Let's go get some berries.
All right. We'll be right out here.
Time for my final weapon. The wet towel.
I better get out of here before the airstrike comes. Safe now. Now that all this is finally over with, I can enjoy this dessert. Oh, I should probably take my medicine first. Where to go?
We're sorry, the number you have dialed is not in service at this time.